हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर मंजू शर्मा, बैक अगेन टू कंक्लूड दिस पोएम द घाघरा इंस्पेट रिटन बाय केकीयन दारूवाला. द पोएट टॉक्स अबाउट वन रिवर इन पर्टिकुलर बट इज एक्चुअली मेकिंग सजेशंस अबाउट nature in general. He talks about the river that has become angry during the monsoon because the water has been released from the flood dams, from the floodgates of the dam, and the river which was only showing slight suggestions, which it must have always done every year, because the poet begins the poem with the expression "and every year." So whatever is happening happens every year. It just happens that way. In the beginning, the river changes its colors. Then at night, somehow cold comes riding on the river belly and takes into its captivity the inanimate and animate objects together. So violent is the river that it appears in spate. Spate is anger that emerges because of some kind of contempt. किसी के प्रति कुछ क्रोध, मतलब किसी के प्रति कुछ वितृष्णा से उगा हुआ, उपजा हुआ एक क्रोध. ये नदी इसलिए नाराज हो जाती है कि मैं हर साल आती हूँ, हर साल दिखाती हूँ लोगों को अपना रौद्र रूप, ये सुधरते नहीं है. मैं अगर प्रकृति में कभी एक बार किसी को लेके जाऊँ, ये हमेशा एक दूसरे को मारते हैं. विपत्ति काल में ये लोग एक दूसरे को परेशान करते हैं. जस्ट एज व्हेन ही सेड केकी दारूवाला सजेस्ट्स दैट व्हेन दे वर स्ट्रैंडेड ऑन रूफ टॉप्स ओनली द चिल्ड्रन हु आर रियली इनोसेंट वंस हैड द करेज टू स्क्रीम आउट फॉर हेल्प टू द रेस्क्यू बोट्स बट द अदर्स स्टेड क्वाइट एंड मेड नो प्रेयर्स फॉर फियर दैट दीज प्रेयर्स could be mistaken by the river, which had its own slang, which had its own argo, its own language. And who knows if the river mistakes this prayer for something else and sends more havoc. So they are very scared. The people are diplomatic enough. They are making no prayers to the skies. They are scared lest the prayers would fall off on them and bring more havoc. And furthermore, when they are really rescued, when they are on places where they are being served with the material, what they do is they make a stampede. They run one another down in an effort to be the first to receive the help. Now the river has receded 10 miles to her flank. Peasants go fishing in rice fields, and women in chauffeur driven cars go looking for driftwood. See the scene of devastation, the aftermath, the picture of the earth after the river has receded, has gone back within its limits. What stays on the earth are fish, poor fish, and peasants go fishing in disturbed waters. Men only delight to take advantage of others who are in misery. Poor fish that have been trapped in the flanks. Flanks are impressions, the deep dug parts of the river, you know, of the earth where the river had swept in. Small pools are formed, small pits are formed, and in these pits are trapped the fish, and people come fishing these, catching these fish. And women in chauffeur driven cars. Chauffeur driven cars suggests that rich people, very rich women, they come to collect driftwood. Driftwood is a special kind of wood that is resistant to water and can be put to several uses. So those who are rich, poor people catch the fish, and rich people come to collect rich resources. But it's when she recedes that the Ghagra turns bitchy, sucking with animal heat. So when it recedes, when it had become angry and swollen, that time it was north, very cold. But when it goes back, she turns bitchy. It is a derogatory word. It is the word of abuse, which the poet uses to say that when it recedes, it becomes terribly hot. Animal heat means a passion which is uncontrollable. A heat that allows for no understanding. So, and also heat also signifies the humidity which comes to exist. Cross eddies diving like frogmen and sawing away the waterfront in a paranoid frenzy. So cross eddied, nadi laut kar gayi hai aur zameen par jo chale honge to unse jo gadde ban gaye hain. So there is eddying type of structures, you know, some pitted structures are there. And sawing away, it has cut itself over the waterfront and has gone back in a paranoid frenzy. लौट के भी गई है तो गुस्से में घूमती घूमती गई है, causing ditches on the land. So this is spate. इतनी नाराजगी है इस नदी को, आई थी क्रोध में और गई भी है तब भी, कि मैं जा रही हूँ, मैंने मुझसे हो गया, because it was needed. The water fell from the skies and I turned into a flood. But why should you kill each other? So in that frenzy, in that annoyance, she leaves marks on the earth. She flees from the scene of her own havoc. This is a very beautiful expression. The river cannot tolerate to see that she has caused havoc. She flees from there. She couldn't believe that 3 days she had been raging on the earth, thrashing with pain. So much of pain it has thrashed upon beings. Behind her, the land sinks. So when it goes back, the land sinks. Men had created streets, maybe with charcoal. But when the river goes back, it shows to the people that their efforts were really stupid efforts. The land sinks. Houses sag on their knees because the houses, because of the water has dug deep into the earth, and therefore the houses sag. घुटने के बल बैठ जाते हैं, घर भी थोड़े टेढ़े मेढ़े दिखते हैं. इन अ फेयरवेल ओबीजेंस, दे हैव टर्नड ओबीडियंट एंड दे हैव बिड फेयरवेल, बिकॉज हाउसेज नो दैट रिवर वुड कम बैक ओनली नेक्स्ट ईयर. एंड माइल्स टू द फ्लैंक द पैडी फील्ड्स विल होल्ड द फिश टिल द मड एंटर्स इनटू अ कॉन्स्पिरेसी विद द सन एंड स्ट्रगल्स देम. सो इन द पैडी फील्ड मच ऑफ द फिश अगेन वुड बी ब्रॉट बैक फ्रॉम द रिवर्स एंड दे विल बी ट्रैप्ड इन द पैडी फील्ड्स एंड आफ्टर द रिवर हैज गॉन बैक दीज फिश will be made subject to the conspiracy, and when the sun, because it is humid, it becomes humid only when there is water down, and the sun too is intense. So this intense heat from the sun will kill the tiny fish who have come to get deposited in the paddy fields and in the small pits. So what is beautiful here? What is specific here? Specific is will hold the fish. What is the future? नदी जो कर गई वो कर गई, लेकिन अभी भविष्य में और destruction बाकी है. और किन का destruction? Destruction of the fish. Fish that were trapped in the pits, in the paddy fields, which covertly suggests that all those who are unfortunate, those who have been misfortunate to have suffered this, whose thatches were blown away, whose dung cakes were transformed into scum, ye gareeb logon ko, ye fish, they are symbolic of the people, the less fortunate ones who have suffered during the floods and will also suffer till they are strangled, till they are killed. So the poem, which has the beginning expression that every year it happens, ends up with the idea that every year millions of creatures are killed. We may have counted the number of people who were killed. We may count even the buffaloes who suffered or may have died. But we generally do not take count of the least fortunate ones and who also suffer the wrath of the river. I would just suggest that you read a poem, A River, written by R.K. Ramanujan, which again is an unorthodox presentation of a river which carries away a woman, a pregnant woman, maybe with twins in her womb, and several buffaloes as well. So these poets, because India is a country that depended long back on monsoons for its wealth, because we are a nation depending on agriculture, and this gets satisfied not largely by rivers but by the monsoon rivers, the seasonal rivers. These seasonal rivers are a guarantee for the paddy to grow, for the crops to grow, but they also are a guarantee that some will be killed. So this humanism, this understanding of humanity, which K.K. Daruvala has shown in this poem, is beautiful, is an example in itself to establish the position of K.K. Daruvala among not only द पोएट्स ऑफ इंडिया और द पोस्ट कलोनियल पोएट्स, ही स्टैंड्स आउट एज अ सेंसिटिव ऑब्जर्वर ऑफ नेचर विच इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ फाइव एलिमेंट्स, बट नेचर विच इज ऑल्सो इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स. सो ही मेक्स अ कंप्लीट एंड अ ब्यूटिफुल विविड एनालिसिस ऑफ नेचर. दिस इज अ पोएम दैट कैन बी अंडरस्टूड फॉर इट्स नेचुरलिज्म and which must also be interpreted for the humanism. That is all for today. Thank you.